What?
What?
What the hell is this?
Harumph! 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 I didn't get a harumph out of that guy.
Give the governor harumph.
Harumph!
You watch your ass.
I see you shiver with anticipation.
Let the show begin.
Hey, everybody, this is David Heretic coming at you with another edition of Reactions, Reviews, and Rants. And tonight...
Tonight!
Okay, we're coming back to Seikima 2. Yes, indeed. Seikima 2 fans, FEELIN, you, come on now. Here we go. Before we go any further, for those of you who are feeling inclined to do all the clicks and the likes and the bibbidi-bobbidi-bob, do me a favor. Before you do all those things, please watch the whole video first, okay? Give me a chance to actually earn those clicks and likes. Now, after the video's done, if you still feel like doing all those clicks and likes, then by all means, feel free to click away. This is a request from Brett Parks, and this is actually Brett Parks' prioritized request for the month of November for being a Silver Tier member on the Patreon page. So, here you go, Brett. Hope you enjoy the show, man. Brett wanted to see me react to this song by Seikima 2 called Masquerade. Now, have I heard the song before? No, I have not. To the best of my knowledge, this does not resonate with me in any way, shape, or form. However, there's always a possibility I may have heard the song in passing and I just don't realize it. So as always, if I start listening to the song and I suddenly go, wait a second, hold on, I recognize this song, I'll let you know.
That's the truth.
You know me, I'm gonna be honest with you guys. This was posted by Damon2, okay? And the video has 428,418 views. It'll get you there. Other than that, there's really nothing else left to say. Link to the original video will be down below in the video description for your viewing pleasure at your leisure. Let's get started. What do you say? Are you ready? Are you ready? Because here we go. All right, here we go. No idea. I'm assuming this is Seikima 2. I'm assuming. Masquerade 720p. Cool. All right, let's do this.
All right, boy, let's do this.
This song is very commercial. It's very commercial. That chorus, absolutely tons of commercial value. I don't know for certain, but I'm going to go on a limb, and I'm going to say that I'm guessing that this was a big hit for them. I don't know if it was or not, but the poppiness, the commercial value of it, yeah, I could absolutely see this being a hit for them. I absolutely could. A lot of radio play, possibly. It's very possible. It could be one of those songs that whenever they play live, the crowd looks forward to. You know, really, they're like, you know, oh, they better play this song. This is like one of those songs that, oh, they better play it live. And I'm not knocking the song. I'm not knocking it. But out of all of the songs I've heard from Seikima II so far, I've heard like four. I think this is my fourth song from them. Hate to say it. I think this is my least favorite. Why is that? Why is it always the poppy songs are just not, I'm just not usually with those?
Whether you like it or not, learn to love it. It's the best thing going today.
It's not bad, though. I want to be very clear. It's not bad. It's a really good song. I'm enjoying it. I'm just, it's not, out of the four I've heard, though, this is my least favorite out of the four so far. Anyway, let's keep going here. Yeah, he must be suffering in that outfit. Nice harmonies. We may have a guitar solo coming up, but I'll have to pause in the middle of it. So let's pause here. God, that lead singer. Oh, God, he must be suffering in that outfit. That outfit looks like it weighs probably about 80 pounds, man. And he's heffing that thing around. Whew! Anyway, the harmonies. I want to take a moment to talk about the harmonies here. Both in the pre-chorus and in the chorus. The two-part harmonies and the three-part harmonies. Very well done. Very well done. Especially considering the fact that this is a live setting, you know, and they're having to do it live, you don't get any retakes. There are no take twos. It's you have to get it on the first shot, and they sound really good. The two guitar players going up into that falsetto range in the chorus, they have to, you know, because it's up high, you know, and I get it. I absolutely get it. And I got to say, their falsetto sounded pretty good. I've heard better. I've heard stronger, but I also have to keep in mind, They're guitar players. They're not professionally trained vocalists. So they're probably doing the best they can with the limited training that they have. So, I mean, they sound good, though. They don't sound bad. It's a little airy, a little breathy, a little thin, but not, I've heard worse. I've heard far worse. So, I mean, they did a good job. They did a really good job. I can absolutely appreciate it. It was in tune. That was the most important thing. Is it that the harmonies sounded good from a pitch standpoint, from a harmonic standpoint. Sounded just fine. Let's see if I'm right about this guitar solo. I don't know if I am or not. Let's see if I am. Okay, I was right. Oh, we lost the Smart approach, you know, going back and revisiting the chorus again. Yeah, I mean, it kind of adds to the finality of, okay, we're hitting the chorus a second time, we're wrapping it up. You know what I mean? It makes perfect sense. It makes total sense. I couldn't help but notice the lead singer dropped the cape and the I don't know what those are called, shroud, I guess. He dropped it all, man. He looks like he dropped about 50 pounds. That's good. Don't have to lug that around the stage for the whole song. That's good. I was right about the guitar solo. The guitar solo sounded good. One section in there about halfway through where you heard the little you heard it, right? I'm sure y'all heard it. That's okay. Look, that's part of the live experience. One of the reasons I go to live shows is to see and hear mistakes. I love, call me a sadist if you want, but I do it for two reasons. One, it proves they're human. And that makes them more relatable. Two, it proves beyond a shadow of a doubt that they're playing live. They're not playing to. They're not just, you know, lip syncing and playing to, you know, using a track. They actually are playing live. Because who in their right mind would put a mistake like that into a track? Nobody would. So, yeah, good stuff. Really good stuff. Let's finish this out, and we'll get to the review. Yeah, I mean, no, you know what? No, I'm going to save it for the review. Let me get my thoughts together. I'll see you in the review, and I'll tell you everything that's going through my mind right now. I promise. Well, there you go, folks. That was Seikima 2 with Masquerade. This was a request from Brett Parks. And this was actually Brett Parks' prioritized request for the month of November for being a silver tier member on the Patreon page. So there you go, Brett. Hope you enjoyed the show, man. Let's just get right to it. On a scale of 1 to 10, I'm going to give that a 7.8. Yep, 7.8. I feel good about that score. Let me tell you why.
Why?
Okay, I'm just going to go on record, and I'm just going to say this right now. This is my fifth reaction to Seikima 2. The first reaction I did was just a bass solo. It wasn't a song. It was just the bass solo, and that's all I did. So I don't really count that as a song. But I've done, this is my fourth song now that I've done to Seikima 2. Out of the four, I'm just going to go on record, and I'm just going to say this. Out of the four, this is my least favorite. Okay, now, Just because it's my least favorite does not mean that the song is bad, okay? Not by any stretch. Look, I would not be giving the song a 7.8 if I thought the song was bad. If I thought the song was bad, we'd be down the ones, you know, or the twos, you know, maybe the threes, but we'd be way down there. No, a 7.8 is actually, by definition, a really good score. But what I feel is a really good song. There is a ton of commercial value, in particular in the chorus in this song. It's a very upbeat, happy feeling, good feeling song. A bit of a switch from what I've heard from them in the past. This is a very major key dominant, which was a little surprising if I'm being honest here. Not usually my cup of tea, but I mean, it works out. It definitely worked out. Yeah, but I see a ton of commercial value in the song, in that chorus in particular. You could use that everywhere. Music, I mean, obviously music, but like movies, television, commercials, yes. All the video games, yes. You name it, you could use it. I have no doubt you could use it. And I get the feeling, now I don't know if I'm right about this, so feel free to correct me if I'm wrong. And I'll be the first to admit I'm wrong. I get the feeling this was a big hit for them. I get the feeling this is one of those songs that whenever they play live, this is one of those songs that the crowd expects to hear, like Detroit Rock City or Rock and Roll All Night from Kiss. You know, this is one of those songs where it's like, okay, we're at the show. We expect to hear this song, and this song. And I bet you anything, Masquerade is one of those three songs that you could bank on it. You can absolutely bet on it and you will win every time. This song definitely has that definite appeal. The musicianship on this, if I'm being honest, out of the four songs I've heard, probably the easiest out of the four. Other than the guitar solo. The guitar solo was impressive, I gotta say. Especially the second guitar solo with all, in particular, coming up toward the end with all the tapping. The tapping was clean. The hammer-ons and pull-offs were clean for the most part. A couple of the arpeggiations, if I'm being honest, were a little bit sloppy, and it sounded like in the first solo, it sounded like his pick may have gotten hung up in the strings. The pick might have gotten stuck, and he had to rip through them. So, I mean, there was that, but like I said, I don't mind that because I appreciate that. That's one of the reasons why I like listening to live performances. I like hearing mistakes. Look, call me a sadist, go ahead, I don't care. I enjoy hearing those mistakes for two reasons. One, it humanizes the musicians. It lets me know, oh, they're humans. They make mistakes, just like I do. That I appreciate that. It, again, creates that connection. Number two, it proves beyond a shadow of a doubt that they actually are playing live. They're not using a track to, you know, lip sync to. So that's always a good thing. The vocalist sounded really good. The guitar sounded really good. Bass sounded really good. Drums sounded really good. Do you see the common theme here? It's all really good. Even the live show was really good. I've seen them do far better live shows than this. This felt reserved. Like, I don't know if this was maybe toward the end of the show. Maybe it was. Or maybe this was like the beginning of the show. And, you know, this was the opening track and they hadn't warmed up yet. That's possible too. There's a lot of possibilities, but to me, that the live show didn't live up to what I've seen from them in the past. That's not to say that what I saw was bad. It just wasn't as strong as what I've seen. So, a 7.8, if I'm not mistaken, that is the lowest score I have given Seikima 2 so far to date. And in all honesty, I do feel that score is deserved. It shouldn't be up in, you know, with the higher scores that the other songs have gotten. I know I've given them eights. I know I gave one of them a nine. Last month, I think I gave them a nine. So, yeah, I feel good with that 7.8. I feel it's appropriate for the song, and that's where we're going to stay. So, 7.8, final score. I have spoken. Well, that's going to do it for this edition of Reactions, Reviews, and Rants. Hope you all enjoyed the show. Hopefully, I was able to entertain you. If I was able to put a smile on your face and brighten your day, then I did my job, and I'm so glad I could do it. If you guys feel like joining the fan base, go ahead and click on that button down there. If you guys want to like the video, go ahead and like the video. If you guys want to ring the bell, go ahead and ring the bell. It honestly doesn't make any difference at all to me, but if you guys feel like doing these things, then by all means, feel free to do so. Well, that's going to do it for tonight, folks. Thank you very much for watching. And as always, this is David Heretic signing off, reminding you to stay fabulous and support each other. Later. Peace.